the ways we live, work and play have changed immeasurably in the last two decades, let alone the last century. And our transport network needs to adapt to that change.
We've got some pretty hefty targets that we're trying to meet, like emissions reduction. We're trying to encourage people to get out of their private motor vehicles and use other forms of public transport.
And when we make our streets and our communities safe enough for everyone, then regardless of your age, your ability, you can have the same access opportunities as everyone else. So it means everyone can get where they need to go in a way that's really good for their own health and for the planet.
And what that means for transport is having more compact urban environments that can access public transport more readily, making it easier for people to get around through walking and cycling, and reducing automobile dependency.
A transport network doesn't just get us from A to B, it supports people to live and work in certain areas, connects us with the people and places we love, and contributes to vibrant, thriving communities.
You think of urban design as designing all the spaces between the buildings and even the relationship of the buildings themselves. Our transport has a huge opportunity to really shape our towns and cities.
Waka Kotahi has a role to play in planning for these communities, where they're not just resilient to the challenges that they're likely to face over the coming decades, but also thrive in those conditions.
Programs like Let's Get Wellington Moving are building a system that provides options for everyone, places designed for people rather than cars. But creating space for other types of transport isn't to force people out of their cars, it's to provide everyone with options.
If we have more people walking, more people cycling, more people getting onto a bus or a train, if we free up that street space for the people who have to drive, that's a better experience for everyone.
It's about access and how do we maintain access to these communities, but also how do we provide access for the people to achieve their social and economic aspirations.
Every year, Waka Kotahi spends billions of dollars on the state highway network, but we also fund other ways of moving people and goods: walking, cycling, coastal shipping, and public transport. So whether it's autonomous vehicles that complement public transport,
it's a level 4 driverless autonomous shuttle to take you on the first and last mile of your journey. A vehicle like this ends up being another option that someone can rely on so that they don't have to use a private car.
Or supporting urban development so people can live closer to their work. We're seeking solutions for the future.
We often talk about future-proofing, and we often think about the capacity for our roads. When we think about that huge array of different electric vehicles, e-scooters and e-skateboards, e-bicycles, e-cargo bicycles, there's really a tidal wave of them coming into this country, and we have a big job to do in preparing for that.
We don't know exactly how we'll be moving in 30 years' time. We do know it'll be different, and the work we're doing now will help make sure Aotearoa is ready.